Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss about half wave, full wave voltage doublers, and I will also discuss about other voltage multipliers. And this is the circuit that showing the application of the voltage multiplier in the generation of the high DC voltage. And this is basically a DC to DC switched mode power supply which converts the low voltage DC to an high voltage DC. And this consists of a high frequency inverter which is basically an H bridge which converts the low voltage DC and, to an AC waveform. And this AC is further stepped up by using this transformer, and this high voltage AC is converted to an high voltage DC by using this voltage multiplier. The voltage multiplier is basically an AC to DC converter, so that converts the low voltage AC to an high voltage DC, and this high voltage DC value depends upon the number of the diodes and capacitors that are present in the voltage multiplier. Voltage multipliers are commonly used for the generation of the high DC voltage in various applications like X-ray generation, laser systems, ion pumps, pinning vacuum gauges, and so many other applications are using high DC voltage, and this high DC voltage is commonly generated by using the voltage multiplier. And here I am going to discuss about half-wave voltage doubler, and this half-wave voltage doubler consists of two diodes and two capacitors, and the first capacitor and diode is known as voltage clamper, and the second diode and capacitor is known as peak holder. For the negative peak at the input, so here this terminal will be negative and this terminal will be positive. Because of this, diode D11 starts conducting and it charges the capacitor C with the voltage Vm in the polarity as shown here. And because of the voltage that is available at this capacitor, so the DC offset of this input voltage has shifted from, instead of 0, it has shifted to Vm. And because of this, the output from the voltage clamper circuit is oscillating between 0 to 2 Vm. Here you can see, because of this voltage Vm that is present during the positive peak and this voltage, so the voltage at this output is oscillating between 0 and 2 Vm, and because of this 2 Vm, the capacitor Cs is charged through the diode D12 to a value of 2 Vm, and the load need to be connected across this capacitor Cs. And this is the full wave doubler. So the full wave doubler circuit also consists of two capacitors and two diodes, but the circuit is changed compared to a half wave doubler. And during the positive peak at the input, that is AC, so the diode D1 starts conducting and it charges the capacitor C1 with the voltage Vm, and it is having the polarity as shown here. And during the negative peak, so the diode D1 is blocked and the diode D2 starts conducting and it charges the capacitor C2 with the voltage Vm, and the polarity as shown here. And the output need to be taken across these two capacitors C1 and C2, which is 2 Vm, that is twice that of the peak voltage of the AC input. The advantage of full wave doubler compared to half wave doubler, here you can see the voltage rating of this output capacitors or Vm. Earlier, if you see, the voltage rating of the output capacitor is 2 Vm. And other advantages are the output voltage ripple frequency is twice that of the AC input waveform. Here, if you see, if it is N50Hz, then the output ripple frequency is 100Hz. So, higher the ripple frequency, so better will be the voltage regulation. And this is the half-wave Cockcroft-Walton voltage multiplier circuit, which is commonly used in the generation of the high DC voltage. And this consists of a series of capacitors and diodes. And here you can see each stage consists of two capacitors and two diodes, and the number of stages that are present in the multiplier depending upon your output voltage of your application. And the disadvantage of the voltage multiplier circuit is, if you are going to higher voltage, the output current, that is load current that is supplied by this voltage multiplier, is drastically reduced, and the output of this voltage multiplier is given by V no load minus delta V naught, which is the drop. Here it is given as 2nVm minus, this is the equation, into IC, I naught is the load current by F into C, where F is the frequency of operation of this AC input. So if you take an SMPS, this frequency is in the order of the kilohertz to megahertz. If you take a normal line frequency, it can be a 50Hz or 60Hz. And from this equation, you can find out that higher the load current, the regulation is poor, and higher the frequency or higher the capacitor value of this voltage multiplier, better will be the regulation. In some tutorials, so one capacitor and one diode is known as one stage. So here you can see, so V naught equal to N into Vm minus V regulation. So this is the V regulation equation. And here you can see, depending upon the value of the N, so if N equal to 2, we are getting a 2 Vm, which is acting as a doubler. If N equal to 3, is a tripler. N equal to 4, you are getting a quadruple. So by this configuration, so you can get an even or odd multiple output voltage at the multiplier output. And this is the circuit that is generating the negative high voltage in some applications, like in X-ray generation, where the negative high voltage is need to be generated. So here, compared to earlier configuration, where you can see the diode is inverted. So because of this inversion, so we are getting a negative output voltage. Here we can see the V naught is equal to minus 4 Vm, and this negative voltage is used in various applications. Thank you for watching my video.